Hey Cedars, Tim here with your midweek update. Hope you're having a great week so far. And I want to let you know some of the things we have coming up in the immediate future and then a little bit beyond that. Some of the things that we've been talking about for a while are finally coming to take place here. So the first and foremost is Joyful Bounty, right? This is our partnership in serving our local community with Compassion Network for those who live in our area that are in need and have a need for food for Easter, right? And so thank you if you signed up to serve. I know it looks like we now have a full team to do that. We're still a tad bit short on the number of bags that we need. So the distribution day is Saturday the 27th. If you are able to donate a bag or two of food, you can go on our website and sign up for that. We're probably about 10 bags short at this point, and so would love to make that up. You can download the grocery list and plus the gift card that's needed and purchase those, bring it in on Sunday, this Sunday during church services, or make arrangements between now and the Saturday the 27th to bring it by the church office, right? But sooner the better so we can make arrangements, right? So that's for Joyful Bounty for Saturday the 27th. The next item that we've been talking about that we'd love for you to participate in is Rooted. Rooted is kicking off on Sunday, the 28th of March. And so you can go in, again, go online, sign up for that. If you have any questions, you can contact Laura or myself. But again, as we talked about back at the all-church meeting, right, one of our goals continues to be, and we're focusing on for 2021, is that idea of melding study of the Word and community. And as Laura and the folks have been talking about on Sundays, right? That is the heart of Rooted. That Rooted is an experience of bringing study, biblical truth, in with community, and building friendships, right? So in the midst of that. So it's a key part of what we're doing here as far as equipping at Cedars. And so if you have questions on that, if you haven't gone through Rooted yet, which is a core foundational class and experience here at Cedars, would challenge you to do so. And again, if there's any questions you have with that, by all means, get a hold of us, and we would love to answer those questions for you. All right, and then coming up in a few weeks after that, as you probably are aware, right, we're in the Lenten season, right? We're in the season of looking forward to the Passion of the Christ, right, to Easter. And so As we've been working on this as a team or planning for this, we have a really, really cool Good Friday service starting from 6:30 to 7:30, 1 hour long, that you'll need to sign up for. But we have some great things planned during that hour, right? So we actually have taken some of the things that you have answered back in the survey, taken some of the ideas out of the survey, and we're pulling together some of the things that will touch in spiritual disciplines for you to be equipped in that, but also participate and experience in the midst of worship and in the midst of communion and the midst of word, right? And so it's going to be an awesome, awesome event. We have some surprises for you of some of the things that we want to do with that night. So we truly need you to sign up because there's some supplies that we'll need to make sure we have available for you if you show up in person, or if you're going to watch it online, we want to make sure we get some of these things that are a bit of a surprise at the moment still into your hands. And in order to do that, we really need you to sign up. So if you could do that, that would be great. And then, of course, on Easter, we'll have the two services at 9:30 and 11. And because of social distancing still, we need you to sign up for that as well. We'll have overflow available. But we'll also make sure that we have a broadcast that goes out that is clean and is viewable as well. So if you still need to stay at home and experience both of these events, Good Friday and Easter, you can do that as well. But as I think about this, right, in closing for Good Friday and Easter, right, as Christ followers, this is a significant holiday that we celebrate. We come year in, year out to remember who Jesus is and what he did in dying on the cross and being the first fruit of resurrection on Sunday. And I know this has been a very difficult year. And as I was thinking about that this afternoon before recording this, I was mindful of several of the festivals that the Israelites would have gone to Jerusalem for. In fact, when this happened with Jesus, the backdrop was Passover. And I have to imagine that of the so many years that they came to celebrate Passover, there had to be years that were maybe just great off the chart years, and they were coming just full of joy to celebrate. But I dare bet that there were seasons of life and years that they were coming to this incredible celebration where it was a difficult year. But regardless of the circumstance they were coming, as we should be coming to Easter this year, knowing that we come to the one true living God who is worth celebrating. He is worth spending time with. He is the focus for our lives. And as we come to meet with him as he waits for us, I expect him to do great works in our hearts. And so the challenge I have for myself, and I guess I would challenge you as well, is as we prepare today, as you're watching this, and we're a few weeks out, that we would be intentional in spending time with the Lord between now and then, and come with a heart that's ready to worship. Also a heart that's ready to be encouraged. But maybe also a heart that's coming to bring our laments to God. Right? It has been a difficult year. And maybe that's where some of us are coming out of. But God is big enough to hear both the praises we have and the expressions of lament or pain that we bring. But we come to him. We come to him. And I think about that. Right? That Hebrew says that we have someone in Jesus who is familiar with our pain and with our suffering. And so I would just challenge us to prepare for Easter. Come to Good Friday. Sign up for that. View it online. Sign up for Sunday for Easter. And come. And so that's my encouragement or challenge for us. That's my challenge for myself as well. That as we walk toward Good Friday and Easter, we're walking to a hope that we have that is secure. All right, so I hope you have a great week. Hopefully you can help supply some of the needs for Joyful Bounty. Sign up for Rooted, and then we'll see you Good Friday and Easter for sure. All right, so take care, and we will see you soon. Bye.